Hello everybody, my name is Larry and today I'm playing a little flash game called Life and Morality. Judging from the comments, I'm gonna enjoy it at least a little bit. Some of the top comments down here are beautiful, sweet, you know, that kind of thing. This game is on Newgrounds. It's a little older. Some of the older comments are from back as far as 2008, but it's a point-and-click flash game, and we're gonna see what it's all about. So I'm gonna hit play. And my mouse is visible so that you guys can see where I'm clicking. You are on a faraway land, alone and afraid. You can't remember how you got here. But you can't shake this feeling that you belong here. Hello, she says. Welcome to your journey. There are several paths you can follow. But be careful, for only one path leads to true happiness. I love the little chirping sounds. That's kind of adorable. You have two paths. To the right, a train with all other living souls is departing for the land of spirits. To the left, you will travel further alone into the forest of unrest. Go your own way, or seek company and support. This is an interesting question, and I guess, as an individual myself, I have a tendency to do things my own way, and sometimes at the expense of personal relationships, pursue the thing that I feel is right for me over what the group is doing. I guess I'll be true to me. Go my own way. A strange cat emerges from the trees. Are you lost? It asks. Cheshire Cat. I can take you through the forest if you agree to let me lead your life forever. That sounds ominous. And I'm gonna say no to your offer, kind sir. Fine, but you will never make it entirely alone. Let's see about that. A personal pursuit of happiness is in some ways selfish, but many would agree that to make time for yourself is not just impartial, it's necessary to live a happy life. Don't let people use you in pursuit of a goal of yours if it means losing track of your ultimatum. That sounds like word salad, but it has a vague sense of positivity. Lost and tired, you have nowhere else to go. Just when you're about to collapse. Hello again. I'm glad you made it.
One stone and look across the room. An elusive smile. But soon, baby, soon. 1 minute for every hour. But time hasn't been on our side, on our side. Still holding on, been waiting so long for that indelible time.
Okay, so I guess that was, Okay, so I guess that was Life and Morality. I guess the message here is that you can't go it alone. And even if you go it alone, at the end you'll always need help. I'm not really sure if there's a moral imperative of being part of the social group. But I think this game was hinting at that kind of concept. I think it was hinting at, you know, the fact that being part of a social group is an integral part of being human. Or I could be reading entirely too much into it. But that was Life and Morality. It's cute. It's sweet. It had a very nice feel to it. It had a very nice... I liked the art style. I liked the music. I liked it. It was very well put together, in my opinion, even though it's just a little short thing. And I'm sure that there's at least one other option, one other path to go down. But thank you very much for watching. But if you want to play this, this was on Newgrounds. It's free. I'll put a link to it in the description below. But thank you very much for watching. And as always, may Darwin be with you.